Hi everyone, it's Michelle, and here's a little bit of chair yoga, something that you can practice when you're not feeling like you want to be so active or you just want the support of a chair. So start sitting down towards the front edge of the chair. Rock a little so that you can feel that both your sitting bones are grounded. Draw your lower belly in, lift it up towards your heart, and just feel how that creates a little more space in your lower back as you sit on the tips of your sitting bones. Let your shoulders draw back, collarbones wide, and then slide your shoulder blades down as you just rest your hands on your lap. Lift through the crown of your head. Feel that your chin is parallel to the earth as you glide it gently towards the back of your throat. And take a moment to maybe close your eyes, but to observe your body and your breath, just as it is. And maybe in your mind, state an intention for why you're practicing yoga right now. As you begin to take deeper breaths. Take a few long exhales through your mouth like you're fogging a mirror so the breath becomes gently more audible. And as you sustain it, both in and out equally, close your lips and start to softly narrow the back of your throat so you continue to create that whisper, allowing your mind and anchor to steady your awareness on. And attuning to your breathing, softly open your eyes. And let's come to stand. We'll practice half sun salutations to get energy flowing through the body. So as you stand up, you want to turn to face your chair, or turn the chair to face you, and step away from the chair about a foot with your feet hips distance apart parallel. Spread your toes, energize your legs by intentionally rooting down so you feel a lift through the center of your spine. Standing tall, so let's flow with the breath. Inhale, raise your arms overhead and watch your palms touch. Feel your shoulders relax. Exhale, bend your knees slightly as you bow, landing your hands on the chair. Inhale, press the chair and elongate your spine forward as you engage the belly in. Exhale, bow a little deeper with your knees slightly bent. Press down with your feet. Inhale, circle your arms as you rise, watching your palms touch. Exhale, join your hands in front of your heart. So that's one cycle. Let's take three more in a row. And if it helps to attune to your breath more easily, close your eyes. Feel that whisper. Here we go. Inhale, circle the arms up. Knees bent slightly. Exhale, fold hands on your chair. Inhale, press the chair, lengthen the spine, shoulders back. Exhale, bow in. Ground your feet, bend the knees. Inhale, circle the arms to rise. Exhale, palms together at your heart. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Press the chair, inhale, halfway up. Exhale, bow in. Inhale, rise, arms reaching. Exhale, centering at your heart. Last time. Inhale, circle the arms. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, lengthen. Halfway, exhale, bowing, rooting down through the legs, inhale, rise tall, exhale, back to the heart. So hopefully you're a little bit warmer, especially in the lower portion of the body, so that we can sit down again. And this time as you sit down, we'll go into a spinal twist, which will actually help to decompress the spine a bit. So again, sit towards the front edge of your chair where you're grounded firmly through your sitting bones, lower belly is drawing in, spine is tall, shoulders are relaxed, back and down. Circle your right hand behind you so that you either reach for the back of the chair or down on the seat. And then as you parallel your feet, keep your knees in the same height so your pelvis and below stay pretty still and grounded. Raising your left arm, relax the shoulders, root down through your pelvis, and inhale up through the center of your spine, sitting a little taller. As you exhale, keep your pelvis and legs still, but rotate your ribcage to your right side, twisting at your waistline, and then cross your left hand either to your left thigh, sorry, your right either to your left thigh or outside of it, pressing the back of the hand, or maybe even the chair, if that's reachable without losing the openness in the front of the shoulders, nor the length of your spine. And now let's continue to twist deeper with a breath. As you ground your feet, your sitting bones, inhale, maybe visualize breathing space up between each vertebra of your spine. Exhale, hollow the belly, and turn the ribcage a little deeper while pressing your shoulder blades down your back. Let's take two more consciously balanced breaths. In and out. In, soften the tops of the shoulders down, and out. Looking forward, exhale, release. Let's take the second side. So backstroke your left arm. So get some stretch into the shoulder too. Either catch the back of the chair or the seat behind your pelvis. Raise the right arm while relaxing the shoulders. Ground as you inhale to lengthen. Exhale, twist at your waistline to your left. Right hand lands on your left thigh, maybe outside of it. Draw your shoulder heads back and down. Sit up a little taller as you breathe in. Exhale to twist deeper along your waistline. So as you keep your legs parallel, your knees at the same level or height, you help to secure your lower spine so that we're not twisting there. Rather, we're twisting at your mid-back, turning the ribcage. Last two breaths. Relax the face. Notice if there's any tension in the mouth. Often happens when we're focusing. One more deep breath. And then gaze forward and release. Let's get a little deeper into the hips, particularly your outer thighs, where the IT bands sit beneath, your outer hips and glutes. So take your right leg, flex your right foot, and cross your right ankle just above your left knee on your back. So you have a figure four shape in your legs, and take a moment to just plant your hands at the creases of your hips and ground the pelvis as you lift the spine. And again, relax the shoulders. Belly is slightly engaged. Breathe here. You can even, with your right hand, gently press your inner thigh without pressing the knee to encourage the leg to splay open. If this is plenty of a hip opener that you're feeling, stay upright. Otherwise, you might hold on to your chair so you don't topple over, and ground your sitting bones while elongating your spine so it's like your heart is what's leading you to bow forward, breath by breath. Continue to lift your navel towards your back to maintain length in your lower spine. And just to add a little more support, let's take two more deep breaths. If you want to add some core work, your balance feels pretty steady, raise your arms overhead like you're holding a beach ball. Draw your shoulder blades down the back and create space in your neck. Wide across your collarbones, take one more deep breath. And on an inhale, lead with your chest to rise all the way up. Let's step your right foot down and switch. Cross your left ankle, flexing the foot over your right thigh. Press your hands onto the creases of your hips on your lap and ground your pelvis, lifting the spine. I already feel hip flexors opening up, psoas opening up. So you might stay here, breathing or holding your chair. Start to fold in, drawing your navel in, inhaling as you lengthen the spine some more, grounding the pelvis as you exhale to explore folding just to the degree that you can maintain integrity in the length of your spine, where the shoulders are not hunching towards the ears and tense, nor the chin dropping to close the throat, and integrity in your breath. Inhaling through the nose, exhaling. One more, inhale. Oh, and if you raise your arms overhead, add a couple of breaths of doing that just so you're even on both sides. Again, draw the belly in, lead with your chest. Inhale to slowly rise up. Nice, let's add a few back bends. So start with your elbows bent like a cactus shape in your arms. And let the fronts of your shoulders gently peel behind you as you feel your shoulder blades close towards each other, retract, and move down the back. And then lifting your heart, let that inspire a little tilt in your gaze up towards the sky. tops of the shoulders relaxing down. Feel that there's space in the back of the neck. The belly is engaged as you root down through your sitting bones, creating space in your lower back. Two more breaths. Feel your collarbones broaden as you breathe across your heart space. Your shoulder blades melt down as you exhale. One more deep breath. And exhale. If you'd like to take the back bend further, backstroke your right arm so the hand lands just behind your pelvis at center on your seat. Raise your left arm, wrapping the left outer upper arm or tricep forward to widen across the top of the shoulder. Plug the shoulder blade down, and then as you lengthen, or as you breathe in, do lengthen from your lower spine up to your chest. Feel your shoulder blades again retract and depress while coiling your chest up. Now, if you need something to support your head, bend your elbow up and let your fingertips meet the base of your skull so that you're not collapsing your head entirely into your neck, causing strain. So let the heart lead your gaze up. Taking two more deep breaths as though you could breathe in and out through the center of your heart in this heart-opening posture. Sort of like a half version of a seated camel pose. On an exhale, release. You might like to just take a moment, roll up the shoulders. Or turn the head, shaking it gently no. A nice little crack in my neck. And let's take side two. So backstroke your left arm so you can feel that range of motion in the shoulder. Land your hand just behind your pelvis at center on your seat. Raise the right arm and rotate the tricep forward, creating more width across the top of the shoulder. Press the shoulder blades down, draw your lower belly into the spine and up, and inhale, ground the sitting bones as you lift the spine out of your pelvis. Exhale, right over the bottom tips of your shoulder blades, feel more of a contraction in your upper back to coil the chest up. And if you want some support for your head, bend your right elbow up towards the ceiling so your hand catches the base of your skull. Keep melting the tops of your shoulders down. Feel the space in the back of your neck. Let's take two more consciously deep breaths, perhaps visualizing it at the center of your heart. Draw in the bottom of your front ribs if you feel hyper-arching in your lower back. And then engage the abdomen to rise up. Release the hands down. Twist to just sort of release the back from that. Inhale, the arms up. Keep your feet still, your knees pointing forward into your right. Exhale, twist at your waistline, lower both hands. Inhale, back to center. To your left, exhale, twist without moving the legs. One more each side. Inhale, center. Maybe this time you grab for the back of your chair with your right hand. Twist. Inhale, center. Maybe the left hand grabs the back of the chair. Exhale, twist. Nice, and then from here, let's take a forward fold standing. So come on up to stand, turn the chair to face you, or you to face the chair. And we'll take a supported pyramid, or Parsvottanasana. So step away from the chair, so that you can see that your stance is feet, hips distance, parallel. Keep your hips facing forward evenly, and step your right foot forward underneath the chair, where your leg can maybe just lightly touch the chair. And then from here, as you hold the chair, step your left foot back so you have about maybe 2.5 feet, 3 feet between your 2 feet. And in this wide stance, keep your hips facing forward, ground your feet, spread your toes, and lift your kneecaps. So without locking the knees, you're engaging the fronts of your thighs or your quadriceps to support the hamstrings. Draw the navel in, and as you inhale, elongate your spine. As you exhale, bow from your hips. Just like earlier when we were bowing, just take it to the depth of the forward fold, where you can maintain space at your throat, chin is slightly lifted away from the chest, and space along the sides of your neck. Your shoulder blades are moving down, the heart is slightly lifted. You might even come down to your elbows, your forearms. Let's take 2 to 3 more deep breaths, engaging the fronts of the thighs. Maybe visualizing breathing into the backs of your thighs or your glutes or lower back, where you might feel this opening up the most. Deep inhale.